The numbers surrounding global trade seem to be impossibly large. Escalating trade tensions between the US and China has seen a corresponding recent escalation in the value of each country's trade threatened by tariffs. But they will only constitute a relatively small fraction of global merchandise trade, around $17 trillion a year, not forgetting another $5 trillion US dollar of global services trade. Nonetheless, always remember that despite these big numbers, trade fulfills a very basic human need, and these tariff proposals go against this. For thousands of years, human beings have used trade to overcome local scarcity. Trade has also increased opportunities for both consumption and production. This is a subtle competitive process that has created the world we have today. But over the last few years, there have been some dissenting voices to this process of globalization. Some have suggested that we are, in a sense, a post-peak globalization, and that the importance of global trade is slowly falling. A number of market participants have also claimed that the global trade regime is unfair to certain countries. However, according to the IMF, global merchandise trade volume growth was 4.7% in 2017, up from 2.5% in 2016. And trade growth was much faster than estimated GDP growth of 3.7%, a key focus point in recent years. What I think is happening is that trade is evolving, as it always does. We see increasing evidence, for example, of increased intra-regional trade held by regional and bilateral trade agreements. In fact, if you look at ASEAN, the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, the traditional key markets of the US, EU, and Japan now each account for less than 10% of its trade. But growing intra-regional trade cannot, I'm sure, compensate for disruption to the main axis of global trade, for example, between the US and China. It was no surprise that market reaction to recent news also suggests that the market takes the possibility of trade disruption very seriously. How do we assess the current situation? We see this as a part of a political problem, as trade tends to be. Often, it is easier to blame structural economic issues on trade than national policy. And there will be political feedback from the impact of tariffs on individual US producers, as we have seen from China. But the more the tariff tit-for-tat gets pulled into a broader debate, the more difficult it may be for either side to compromise. And this risks potentially the introduction of more tariffs down the road. I don't expect a global trade war. I think that almost all participants are keen to avoid this. To back the point I made earlier, they realize that trade does fulfill a very basic human need. But finding a way out of the current impasse could be difficult and time-consuming. As a consequence, I wouldn't be surprised if volatility stays at current levels for quite some time, different to 2017. So while our base case is that there is no trade war, there will be no full trade armistice either. The war of words could continue for quite some time. Market concerns therefore won't subside immediately, but the focus should increasingly move to other fundamentals to investors' benefit. But we will watch this, of course, closely and keep you updated.